Chapter 4, Column Buckling. In this chapter, we will talk about stability of structure, buckling models, Euler's formula. Stability of structure. Column buckling is depend on the applied stress. So if the applied stress is less than allowable stress, the column will not buckle. However, if the stress is more than allowable stress, the column will buckle as shown in the figure. Okay, so let's look at the buckling model. So there is a column ABC subjected with a force P, and there is a rotational spring located at C, and both end AB are pin connected joint. Okay, so let's look at the free body diagram of ABC. So if the column ABC buckle, so there is an angle changes of theta. Okay, so for the rotational spring, the M equals to K multiply with two changes of theta. K is the spring constant. Okay. So let's look at the stable and unstable of the column. So for the stable state, the column will back to the original position once the force was removed. However, for the unstable state, so the column will keep deflect once the force was removed. Okay, so next is comparing the restoring force for both stable and unstable state. So for the stable state, the restoring force is greater than the applied force. And for the unstable state, the restoring force is less than the disturbing force. Okay, so next is the total potential. So the total potential for the stable state is increased, while the total potential of the system for the unstable state is decreased. So therefore, for the buckling load, PCR is occur in between the changes of the from the stable state to the unstable state. So let's look at the buckling of the column ABC. Okay, so we focus on, so if we consider the AC and we draw the free body diagram for the section AC. So from previously, the for the rotational spring, the M equals to K multiplied with two changes of theta. And for the critical load, okay, so if we look at the free body diagram AC, so we take this point C where the summations of moment at C equals to zero. So we can derive the M equals to critical load multiply with half L, then multiply with sine changes of theta. Okay, so if we compare both equations from the rotational spring and the critical load, so we can get the equations. Okay, so as stated, and since for the angle theta is quite small, so we can conclude that the sine changes of theta is near to changes of theta. So therefore, when we substitute to the equation above, so we can get the PCR equals to 4K divided by L. So this is a critical load for this column ABC. Euler formula. So let's look at the example for the column AB. So I just cut a section in between AB at Q, where there is a distance x from A, and we look at the free body diagram of AQ. So from this free body diagram AQ, so I can derive that M equals to negative PY. Y is the distance between P and Q. Okay, so distance P and Q. Okay, so next. Okay, so from the Euler formula, so d square y over dx square equals to m over ei. So after that, if I substitute the above equation into the Euler formula. So I will get negative, okay, so I will get d square y over dx square equals to negative py divided by ei. Okay, so I simplify the formula, so I will get d square y over dx square plus py divided by ei equals to 0. Okay, so let's assume that q square equals to p over ei. So if we substitute into above equation, we will get d square y over dx square plus q square y equals to 0. Okay, so this same as differential for simple harmonic motions, above equation will become y equals to a sine qx plus b cos qx. So if you forgot how to derive the equation for simple harmonic motions, so you can click the YouTube link below to recall back your memory. Okay, so for this equation, so we need the boundary conditions at point A and point B. Okay, so for the boundary condition at point A, so when x equals to 0, y equals to 0. So if substitute to above equations, we will get b equals to 0. The same, okay, so second boundary, for the second boundary conditions where the and x equals to l, y equals to 0, so you will get a sine ql equals to 0. So for a sine ql equals to 0, either a equals to 0 or sine ql equals to 0. So let's take sine ql equals to 0, so ql must be equals to n pi. So from our assumption where q square equals to p over ei, substitute to equation above, so we will get n pi over l bracket square equals to p over ei. Okay, so rearrange the equations and we will get the p equals to n square pi square ei over l square. Okay, so we take the smallest value of p where the n equals to 1. So the critical load for this model is equals to pi square ei over l square. So for the circular cross section, so the critical load equals to pi square ei over l square, and the moment of inertia equals to area multiplied with the r square, where the r is radius of gyrations. So we know that the critical stress equals to the critical load divided by a. Therefore, by combining all the equations, we will get the critical load is equals to pi square e divided by brackets l divided by r brackets square, where l divided by r is slenderness ratio. Okay, so let's look at so if we want to plot the graph for the critical stress versus the slenderness ratio, okay, so we need to look at the material properties. So let's assume that the yield stress for the steel is 250 MPa and the Young modulus is equal to 200 GPa. So by substitute above informations or parameter into the equations, so we will get the slenderness ratio around 89. Okay, so by plotting the graph for the critical stress versus the slenderness ratio, so from 0 to 89, the yield stress will remain constant, 250, and starting from the 89, it will decrease. Okay, so based on the equations for the critical stress. So let's look at question 4.1. So a 2-meter pin-ended column of square cross section is to be made of wood, assuming E equals to 13 GPa, allowable stress equals to 12 MPa, and using a factor of safety of 2.5 in computing Euler's critical loads for buckling, determine the size of the cross section if the column is to safely support a 100 kN load and B a 200 kN load. So for a 100 kilonewton load, okay, so the equation for the safety factor is equals to the critical load divided by applied load. So we know that applied load is 100 kilonewton and the safety factor is 2.5. Therefore, the critical load is equals to 2.5 multiplied with 100 kilonewtons, so equals to 250 kilonewton. And given the parameter length equals to 2 meter, and then the E equals to 13 GPa. So by applying the critical load formula, so we will get the I moment of inertia is equals to 7.794 multiplied with 10 power of negative 6 meter power of 4. So from the questions, it does state that the cross section of the column is a square. So therefore, the moment of inertia I equals to a power of 4 divided by 12. By solving the equation, we will get A equals to 98.3 mm. So round off will be near to 100 mm. So for the A, we must round up. If we round down the value, so the critical stress will be less, because the PCR is directly proportional to the moment of inertia. Okay, so for the stress, we know that the stress equals to P divided by A. So by substituting the applied load divided by the area, so equals to 10 MPa. And since that the stress applied is less than stress allowable, so the cross section is acceptable. Next is for the 200 kilonewton load. Okay, same approach. So we, from the calculation, we will get the PCR equals to 500 kilonewton. And then we apply the Euler formula. So we will get the I equals to 15.588 times 10 power of negative 6 meter power of 4. So for the square of a side A, so the I equals to A power 4 divided by 12. So we will get A equals to 116.95 millimeter. So we, if we want to round off, will be 117. Okay, so if we substitute into the stress equation, so we will get the stress is around 14.62 MPa. Okay, so from here, since the stress applied is more than the allowable stress, so the cross-section area is not acceptable. Let's look at another questions. Question 4.2. Two rigid bar AC and BC are connected as shown to a spring of constant K. Knowing that the spring can act in either tension or compression, determine the critical load for the system. Okay, so we use delta as the deflection at point C, and we look at the free body diagram for section AC. Okay, so we use sum of the moment at point C, so we can get the reaction A equals to 3 P delta divided by L. After that, we look at the free body diagram for BC, and we use sum of the moment at C equals to 0, and we can obtain that the RB equals to 3 P delta divided by 2 L. Next, apply sum of fx equals to 0, therefore negative ra minus rb plus k delta equals to 0. Therefore, we will get the critical load for this column is equals to 3 kl divided by 9. The critical load is depend on the effective length, and the effective length is depend on the connections at both ends. So for example, A, if one fixed end and one free end, the effective length is equals to 2L. And for B, if both end pin, so the effective length equals to L. And C, for one fixed end and one pin end, the effective length equals to 0.7L. And lastly, for both end fixed, the effective length equals to 0.5L.